Let's take a look at some different aggregates. The goal of an aggregate is to reduce many different values down into just one. We create an aggregate by using an aggregate function. Here's some of the different aggregate functions that we're going to make use of. So we can use these functions to get the number of values inside of a group of values. We can sum a bunch of numbers together. We can find the average, the minimum, and the maximum. As usual, the best way to understand this stuff is to write out a little bit of SQL and just execute it. So I'm going to go back over to my editor, and I'm going to write in a query here that is going to select the maximum value out of the ID column from comments. So I want to find the comment with the largest ID. I'm going to run that, and I get back 100, which makes sense because we've got about 100 comments or so. We can also find the minimum ID, run that, and we get 1. We can find the average ID, which would be around 50.5. We can do a count, which will tell us how many IDs we have. And then finally, we can sum them all together, which will probably just give us a really large value. Yeah, there we go. So the one thing you'll notice around all these different aggregate functions is that we are taking a big column of values here. So ID has many values inside of it. And we are doing some kind of calculation or math operation on all those different values and returning just one single value. When we make use of an aggregate function, we cannot do a normal select next to it. So for example, I cannot sum ID and also just select ID at the same time. If I do so, I'll end up with an error message like so. We're going to most frequently use these aggregate functions by themselves or as a part of a larger group by statement, which is why we're talking about group by and aggregate functions at the same time. Now, just to make sure this stuff is super clear, just a quick diagram here. So we can imagine that maybe we wanted to find the maximum value out of the photo ID column on the comments table. So for that, we could do a max on photo ID, and it would give us the maximum number value out of there, which in this case on this diagram would be 5. If we did a minimum, the minimum value would be a 4. The average would probably be about, 4.9, and so on. You get the idea. So these different aggregate functions operate on a bunch of different values and give us back one single value. And again, we can only use them without doing a select on the same line. We cannot select a column and use an aggregate at the same time, or we end up with an error like so. Okay, so aggregate functions, doesn't seem like the worst thing in the world. Let's take a pause right here. We'll come back in the next video, and that's where we're going to start to see some more interesting things, specifically mixing together group bys and aggregate functions.